It's one small step for man, one giant leap for mankind.
It was 50 years ago this month when millions of people around the world were glued to their TVs and radios and heard Neil Armstrong utter those now famous words as he became the first human to set foot on the moon. The sheer technological and mathematical feat of launching a rocket and sending humans more than 200,000 miles through space to land on the moon and then return safely to Earth is mind-boggling. Without the computing power we have today, it's no wonder that over 400,000 people worked on the Apollo project. Of course, for all the advances in technology, I still can't get a cell phone with a battery that can get me through a busy day, so in some respects, it seems like we haven't made much progress in the last 50 years. That said, given that this month is the 50th anniversary of the moon landing, I thought it would be fun to take a look at technology developed for or used during the Apollo missions that still has an impact on our everyday lives today. So speaking of phones, that handheld computing device that you use all day long utilizes these magical little things called integrated circuits. Now, integrated circuits weren't invented specifically for the Apollo missions, but it was a need for light, compact, powerful computers that caused NASA to build the Apollo guidance computer using this promising but relatively unproven technology. Their use on the Apollo missions and the need to test these chips by subjecting them to extreme temperatures and G-forces is, in part, what helped accelerate the silicon chip revolution that served as the launch pad for much of today's technological innovation. Have you ever flown on a Boeing 777 or Airbus 320? Instead of using traditional systems of pulleys, cables, and hydraulics, these aircrafts are piloted by a system called fly-by-wire that essentially takes the pilot's input and leverages a computerized flight model to actually fly the aircraft. The Apollo spacecraft was a groundbreaking demonstration of this technology. As amazing of a pilot as he was, Neil Armstrong would never have been able to manually control the lunar module's 2 rocket engines and 16 thrusters. A computer had to be used to perform all the split-second mathematical calculations required to control the module based on the human input from the astronauts. This was the early beginnings to the fly-by-wire systems that are commonplace today. Have you sold any custom sunglasses to your customers lately that come with scratch-resistant lenses? Well, NASA pioneered the development of a highly abrasion-resistant coating to protect the surfaces of equipment from the harsh environments in space and on the moon. That same technology was later employed to make the lenses of glasses more scratch-resistant. How many of you have ordered one of those fancy new memory foam mattresses that are all the rage? Memory foam was actually developed in the late 60s to help absorb shock in the seats used in NASA spacecraft. Today, it's used not only in these mattresses, but also in football helmets, shoe insoles, and more. Now, here's something that I use every day to communicate with customers, colleagues, and the commonsku home office. This wireless headset. Did you know that when Neil Armstrong set foot on the moon and uttered those now famous words, that he was speaking into a wireless headset using technology created by Pacific Plantronics? Yeah, the same company known today as Plantronics who manufactures this headset that I use every day. I could go on, but suffice it to say that the research and development done during the Apollo missions 50 years ago has resulted in all sorts of new products that are a regular part of our lives today. A whole new round of innovation is happening all around us as government and private industry look toward a return to the moon and ultimately a mission to Mars. Where do you think those innovations will bring us over the next 50 years? Thanks for watching. We'll see you next time on Tech Talk.